storms raging today, haven't we?
Exactly.
But thank God, I think they've all passed over.
Thank you.
Tonight, we are living in the last days.
Amen.
We know that scripture's going to tell us shortly about what's going on, and I know that people have been preaching it for years, but we see it even more evident as we live in this day and time about the end being near. And scripture gives us some pointers to that. One thing is when you look in most of the churches, there are very few in the churches. Now you see those mega churches that, you know, people go to, and it would be nice to say that everybody in there is going to seek God, to worship God, and to hear God's word, and to learn of Him, and for it to change their life. I would love to say that. But in the churches today that a lot of people, they're not really going for a change.
Amen.
You know, they want Christ, but they want him in their own way.
Amen.
And it's sad to say, but there's a lot of them. I'm not saying everyone. I'm not saying every church. But there's so many, and it's getting more prevalent as we go through time. But I want to share something with you here. So can you tell what this is? In what? In a mirror. Okay, it's the reflection of an apple. Okay? So you look at it and you're thinking, hey, you know, apple, love to have one. You know, especially those red, big, juicy ones. I mean, those things are so good. Some people like the green ones and different kind. I like to get those big red juicy ones. I mean, it'll just flow down your arm, you know. Those things are so good. So we're looking at this apple, and we're thinking, man, that really looks good. And I see it's a perfect apple. But look at this other. So actually, that perfect apple was only an illusion. It looked like a beautiful, perfect apple, something you would desire, but hey, who wants to get a hold of this? I mean, I can just see somebody going to the grocery store and taking a bag and filling their bag full of half-eaten apples. Not. Okay? So really this is an illusion, and there's a lot of things going on right now that are really like an illusion. And let's find out what we're talking about here. Illusions, two meanings I've got here. A thing that is or is likely to be wrongly perceived or interpreted by the senses. Second part, a false idea or belief. There's a lot of that going on. There's a lot of, hallelujah. Praise God, it sounded rough. She's like, peace, Pastor. But there's a lot of illusions going on. I heard of one today. I heard of a young couple in the Lord. They're probably in their 40s and 50s, but they're young in Christ, and was, you know, kind of trying to find out why they're, you know, not attending church. And they let us know that they're doing Bible study at home and prayer time at home. Well, they know very little about God. So who's going to teach them? When the Ethiopian, the eunuch, was out in the desert, and I believe it was Philip that was transported over there, just all of a sudden he says, wow, you know, I'm in another place here. And the Ethiopian was reading out of the book of Isaiah, and he asked him, he said, do you understand what you're reading? He said, I can't understand it unless someone.
Teach it. Come on,
Whitney. Hey, we all need it.
Amen.
I need it. I have to study to understand the scriptures.
Amen.
And I have to be careful what I study and who I get it from.
Amen.
So I have to learn, church.
Amen.
I have to learn what the scripture says. And if you haven't got a clue and you sit down and you begin to read it, and you can take whatever out and use it and push aside the other if you want to. But the scripture, all of it should be studied. All of it should be divided equally. Amen. We should understand it because we should even understand the history of scripture. You know, especially with Paul's writing. A lot of times Paul would minister to a certain culture. And the things he said wasn't for every culture. It was strictly for them. So we have to be careful when we study God's word. So I'm going to share some scripture with you here and just kind of let you know about you know, being careful about what you listen to, what you see, what you believe, and kind of help you understand the day and time that we're living in. I'm probably not going to go real deep into this, but I'm going to kind of give you an overview of it. Because you need to understand, because, I mean, I've heard some people say some off-the-wall things. One of them was from a supposed to be Christians. I don't think God minds if we cuss every now and then. That was one of them. I'm like, well, kind of where did you get that? Well, you know, he was talking about a donkey. And I said, well, he was calling the animal what the animal is. Where did you get that from? I just don't think you just carry it too far. You got to know the day we're living in. Okay? Let's read a little bit. 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 8. Scripture tells us, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Now, we're picturing a lion jumping on us and eating us physically. That's not what it is. This is a spiritual context. It's people coming in and trying to teach you something other than what the Word of God says. Trying to deceive you. Trying to get you to walk in doctrines that make no sense at all. Y'all just forgive me for this. God made this wood. Oh, I love it so. Let me worship this wood. You say, well, that was in the Old Testament. No, that's going on today. People are worshiping trees. They're worshiping animals. They're worshiping anything that they can worship that makes them feel part of life. And you know, it's like some people are just searching for their identity. I'm just trying to find out who I am. Can I tell you who you are? If your birth certificate tells you you're a man, then you're a man. If your birth certificate tells you you're a woman, then you're a woman. Amen? That's all you need to know. And you need to also know that you were created in His image. Amen? You're a child of God. That's what you need to know. What you really need to know, what you really need to find out, is what purpose and what plan God has for your life.
Yes, amen.
Amen? That's what you need to find out. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1 and 2 says, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies in hypocrisy, and having their conscience seared with a hot iron. We have all kind of beliefs. You know, in India, you know, they worship who they worship. In India, they have a doctrine that they've taken a little bit from here and a little bit from here, so that everyone can feel comfortable in their spiritual state. Now, there's some people, they're taking this, and they're taking a little bit of this, a little bit of this, and they're worshiping so everybody can feel comfortable in their spiritual state. Church, that right there, this Holy Bible, is what you need. And you need to study it and you need to understand it. In Matthew chapter 24, it gives you a pretty clear picture of what we're going through in these latter times. Matthew 24, beginning with verse 7, it says, "For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in divers places." Now, we've had that for years and years and years. "All these are the beginning of sorrows. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake." It's beginning to happen in the United States. People are beginning to be jailed for sharing their beliefs. The schools are allowing whatever to come in. When they're allowing a man to come in dressed as a woman and him say that he's, I don't know what word to use here, posing or trying to be as a woman and looking more like something out of a wild book, and trying to deceive the children. Can I tell you something? Your children, they start learning from a young age. What you feed them with is who they will be when they get grown. But you know what's taking place now? People are finding out that they can be comfortable at home with their children now. They don't have to get on to them, and they don't have to, you know, run them down here and there. All they have to do is put an iPad in their hands. That's all they have to do. And those children learn from everything that's within the iPad or within the tablet. That's where they learn. And at a young age, they've got control of it because it's mostly learning helps. You know, they learn how to add. They learn colors. They learn shapes. They learn animals and stuff like that. So they get interested there and they stay with that thing. I've seen children that, man, you could take them out to eat and set that thing up there. You wouldn't have a bit of problem out of them. They'll eat one or two fries, half of a chicken finger, and that's all they're going to eat. But they're going to sit right there and take in everything that's there. So as they get older, you're like, that works pretty good. Let's promote them to the internet. But let's put parent block on there. Parent block is good. Parental block is good. But still, there is so much that they learn from this. So this is the mindset that you have today. And I'm watching video after video of children standing up in the teacher's face, cussing them, and then a brawl breaks out. Man, I never. Woo! Because they knew that boat paddle from the principal would be coming their way. Amen. But it's not happening today. So verse 9 says, Then they shall deliver you up to be afflicted and shall kill you. You shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. Verse 10. And then shall many be offended and shall betray one another and shall hate one another. You see this happening today. And many false prophets shall rise and deceive many. And because iniquity shall abound or shall increase, the love of many shall wax cold. But he that endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. There was a lady that was in the courtroom, and she had her moment. So she had 114, I believe it was marbles or something like that. And she was putting them in a glass jar. You could hear them every time she put them in there. Each marble represented how many times this one person stabbed this other person. 114 times. Was reading in the news where a boy killed his grandparents. Reading in the news where a child killed their mother. I mean, it's happening in so many large quantity of numbers that it's just amazing. So sin is increasing and love is decreasing.
Amen.
We're living in this day. Don't let people give you an illusion that things are okay, because things are not. One thing you can depend on is that God is still God, and he's got a remnant that's going to stand up and be true to him. Amen? So for combating these illusions, 2 Corinthians chapter 10, beginning with verse 3, it says, "For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ." Where does all this stuff begin? It begins in your thoughts. How can people think about killing their parents? How can people think about killing their grandparents? How can this be? It's time we go to war against this. Do you understand? It's time we stop letting the enemy send an illusion our way and think that we only need God for certain things. We need God for everything. He's the one that has given us bread. He's the one who has given us life. He's the one that provides for us, that protects us, that makes a way where there seems to be no way. God is the one, and we've got to have him in every area of our life. We've got to allow him to cast down these imaginations. We've got to allow that. We've got to have God's help. We can't allow the enemy to lie to us, to deceive us. We need God's word. I've seen times where, you know, people would come and there would be music and singing and worship, and they would just all in it. I mean, they was like just wallowing in it. And then once the word starts coming forth, they would walk out and leave. Over and over again. I've seen praise teams, after they finish their thing, leave. Not hear the word. All they want to do is perform. I have seen it. Seen people, this one man told a pastor. Pastor asked him, well, actually it was evangelist. The evangelist asked him, said, so how did you enjoy service tonight? He said, well, I love to sing. I love that song that you and your wife sang. I love music. I love singing. He said, I just don't like preaching. Period. He said, I come to church and I listen to the music. He said, I don't care nothing about the preaching. Don't care nothing about the word. Believe in a lie. Illusion. False hope. False salvation. You don't like the word, you don't like Jesus. Because in the beginning was the word, and the word was made flesh. Amen. Hallelujah. So Satan was the song leader. Amen. And that music was something else. So he's deceived people into loving the music but hating the word. So what has he done? He's deceived people into liking something that moves their emotions but yet hating the one that can change your life.
Amen.
Amen. So, just like, go back to that, the first. One more. See, Satan is giving people an illusion. It looks good. It looks appealing. It looks tasty. Okay? You desire it. But when you really find out what it is, come to this next one. Then what? When you really know, when you really find out the truth, it's not very appealing. We've got to allow God to reveal his truth to us. We need church. And I didn't really choose this message with the rain. You know, I didn't look at it with the rain. Well, this is a good night to throw down on people that didn't come to church. That's not it. I know what the storms are, you know, and I know there's some people that they don't like it. You know, they don't like the storms. I'm not going to follow them hard. But I'm just telling you, we need to be in God's house. We need to hear God's word. We need to hear the truth of God's word. We need to understand the truth of God's word. Because I'm telling you, people get some crazy things in their mind. And this person that told me it was okay to cuss, that God was okay with the, you know, us cussing every now and then, I've watched that person study God's word. I've seen their Bible. Your Bible's highlighted all through the book, from the front to the back. Little notes out to the side of what God was speaking. And then they want to say this. An illusion. Deceived. We need God's word. Amen. We need God's word. We need the truth of God's word. Hallelujah. Praise his name. I don't know, I just kind of feel like I've been preaching some tough messages. You know, a few of y'all hanging in there with me, hallelujah. But I'm just trying to give you God's word. I'm trying to I'm trying to help us be freed some of these things that we know is tormenting us. I want our eyes to be open, because one day, and it's here in the United States, you're going to be required to do some things in order to live. You're going to be required. If you want to eat, whatever. Some people said that before the mark of the beast came, that the church was going to be gone before they started putting the chips in. Hey, it's in the United States. If you saw the news years ago, there's a company in the West, I can't even think of where it's at right now, that just about everybody in there had the chip put in. And they had them on TV. Oh, this is great. All we do is walk up here, do like this with our hand. The door opens, we go inside. If we want something from the vending machine, we just walk over there and do like this. Punch our numbers in, and there it is. This is great. I mean, it's here. And then a lot of people said we would be out of here. The church would be raptured before it ever started. An illusion. I was asked this question about the 7 years of tribulation. Are we going to be out of here before it even starts? We're walking into it right now. We're seeing the things happen that the Bible tells about in the first 3.5 years. We see it right now. We see things going on right now. To say we are in the 3.5, I can't tell you 100%, but I can tell you we're walking into it. You say, well, is Jesus going to come before or in the middle of it or afterwards? I want to tell you this. Be ready.
Amen.
Be ready. I'd be ready for pre-tribulation period rapture. That way, if it's mid, you'll still be ready. Amen. I'm telling you, be ready now. Be ready, church. Be ready. Father, thank you for your word, your love, your mercy, your grace, Lord, for everything you've done, all that you're doing, all that you're going to do, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I have to thank you for this, because I've looked in the past and I remember in the past all the things that you've done for me for 60 plus years, Lord. I've looked and seen the things you have done. I've heard of the things when I was a child, how the enemy tried to take me out. But God, you had mercy. So therefore you had a plan. And I see things that you're doing right now, and I thank you for it. And just from reading your word, there's something ahead that I need to praise you for. That's my future. Thank you for it. God, help us to have a hunger for your word. Help us to seek you. Help us to dig in your word, Lord, to understand it, to know the truths of it. Let us not be deceived, Lord. Open our eyes, open our understanding to the truth. Father, I give you all the praise and all the glory for this. In Jesus' lovely name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name.